man, I can't become my father. When it's all been said and done, his completions won't complete me. I've divided me by one. I'm the answer to his riddle. I'm the caution of his wind. I'm the spoolage between tongue and teeth beneath his trembling grin. And I dare in my revision, for I dare not suffer twice. And I dare not reinvent the past, and I dare not be the Christ. And I welcome any sufferer, and I welcome any Saul, sitting in this room on wooden bench waiting for joy to call. And I suffer here alone, Lord, perturbed by my every thought. How I've tried to strip them to the bone, I've struggled and I've fought. Every jealous warped intention smuggled sewn into my genes. Every hidden mongrel tendency exploiting me and me.
Each time I put them under, but still they won't attest me. I cry through the thunder, you storm right past me. I search and I ponder, I question and wonder. I'm roaring a thunder, please help me.
I've been waiting here for what now seems the better of an hour. I raised every crippled question from the dead and given power to the absence of my sanity, the presence of a fear that lies in between forgotten dreams that pile up every year. Up above the highest testaments, down below the wooden floor, there's a gutted room, the ragged noon beneath the hidden door. Deep within you'll find the attributes of every sunken man who must bang his head against the dead each day he tries to stand. And he's standing pressed against the very woman that he loves, kissing eyes and lips, embracing hips, surrendering to a touch. And just at the very moment that he touches heart to heart, she pulls from his touch, cause it's too much to mend what's torn apart.
Each time I put them under, but still they won't attest me. I cry through the thunder, you storm right past me. I search and I ponder, I question and wonder. I'm roaring a thunder, please let me in.
It's so hard to be the man I would be if hatred and fear no longer appeared. I swear
she's sweet. She's from Russia and she wants to be in the movie. She's my new best friend. Hello? 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 Anyway, where was I? Oh, right. This woman, Shelly. She says you go back through past lives, incarnations, and you get in touch with everything that makes you do stuff in this life. Like, say you were an addict or nuts or something, or like stuck in old habits, you know? Like you have fears of elevators and spiders and snakes or weird stuff like clowns and opera singers, anything sort of freaky, you know? Well, it all comes up through past life regression, so you get pulled back through what she calls the slipstream. It's karma, you know? Indian stuff from millions of years ago, the Akashic Records or something like that. Anyway, this woman, she's totally awesome. It's awesome. Totally awesome. It comes up through past life regression, so you get pulled back through what she calls the slipstream. She'll walk you through the stuff, you know, like get you to clean up your side of the street. My yoga teacher told me about her. You ought to try yoga. Have you ever done yoga? Oh, you ought to try yoga. And wheatgrass and colonics. It's phenomenal. Anyway, she charges like $300 an hour, and she's got this place in Culver City. Her name's Shelly something. I don't know. It's one of those names you can't say, but like French or something. Anyway, her first name's Shelly, and she's Shelly, and versus bright red Chinese dress. She's got this hello dog, a poodle called Tiddles, but you go in there, into her place, you know, and she does this channeling, these aura readings. It's totally awesome. And oh, she says that all this stuff, life,
anyway,
everything,
was
a slipstream, an illusion, a dream. Felix? That's all it is.
A dream within a dream.
What?
A dream within a dream. Edgar Allan Poe. Sorry, I overheard you talking. A dream within a dream.